Hello, I'm Tim Butters, the Deputy Administrator for the Pipeline and Hazardous Materials Safety Administration, commonly known as PHMSA. PHMSA is responsible for the safe operation of nearly 2.5 million miles of hazardous liquid and gas pipelines that crisscross our nation, which deliver energy to American homes and businesses. We also have responsibility for the safe transportation of nearly 1 million daily shipments of hazardous materials by land, sea, and air. We know it's important for those responding to transportation emergencies involving hazardous materials to know what materials they're dealing with and what actions that need to be taken to help protect themselves, the public, and their communities. As a firefighter myself, I've responded to many hazardous materials incidents and have relied on the Emergency Response Guidebook to identify those products involved based on the UNID number and what to do or what not to do, and most importantly, how to get in contact with product manufacturers to get additional information or assistance. At PHMSA, we understand the importance of first responders having accurate information during those first critical minutes of a hazardous materials incident and having reliable recommendations about what initial actions to take. Making the right decision during those initial phases of an incident will often determine how quickly the incident is resolved. It is for this reason that the Emergency Response Guidebook was developed as a resource for the emergency first responder. It provides critical initial response information for the safety of the responder, the public, and the community. So, what is the ERG? It is a resource or guidebook designed to aid trained emergency responders who are likely to be the first to arrive at the scene of a transportation incident involving hazardous materials. The ERG is organized into several sections based on what information is available or what is needed. The first section, or the white pages, contains important background information and reference data, including important telephone numbers. The yellow bordered section is a listing of hazardous materials or dangerous goods by UNID number in ascending order, referenced against the name of the hazardous material. It also references the appropriate action guide page for that specific product. The blue-bordered pages contain an index listing of dangerous goods in alphabetical order, and it also references the UNID number and the appropriate action page. The orange-bordered pages provide all of the recommended safety actions, a crucial section of the guidebook. It also lists the type of product associated with this action guide. Now let's discuss some of the visual guides that will help you identify hazardous substances. The ERG includes a placard guide, which will help you identify the hazardous substance that is being transported. Placards are required on transport vehicles or freight containers. They are 10.8 inches on point, diamond-shaped, and are hazard class color-coded. Some placards include a four-digit number. Placards should be one of the first sources of information to look for upon arrival at the scene. Labels are identifiers required on hazardous materials packaging. They are diamond-shaped, nearly 4 inches on point, and identify hazard class by symbol, color, and sometimes name. Shipping papers, also known as manifests, bills of lading, or shipping documents, must accompany hazardous material shipments. They provide vital information needed to identify the hazardous material that is being transported. For those of you who are familiar with the ERG, let me outline what's new for the 2012 edition. An index of dangerous goods in order of ID number, located in the yellow bordered section. An index list of dangerous goods in alphabetical order, found in the blue bordered pages. A table of initial isolation and protective action distances. A table of water reactive materials that produce toxic gases, which you'll find in the green bordered table. Added table 3 for 6 gases that are toxic by inhalation, along with an updated list of initial isolation and protective action distances for those products. We've added a boiling liquid expanding vapor explosion, or BLEVI, chart to the fire and spill control section. We've added an improvised explosive device, or IED, safe standoff distances chart to the criminal terrorist section. And various sections have been expanded and/or revised. You can get the 2012 ERG on your smartphone, too. Visit PHMSA at phmsa.dot.gov to download the app. We appreciate what you do to protect us, and we hope the 2012 Emergency Response Guidebook will assist you. Thank you, and stay safe.